Al was an Army intelligence officer and a very successful business executive. Alberto went from being a nun to a teacher to a principal. These are just solid people here in the community. In 1982, they bought their dream home and wanted to keep the weeds out of the driveway, wanted to keep the weeds away from the pool, and started spraying Roundup. Bought a couple other pieces of properties. Nobody ever told them it was dangerous. They saw the ads on TV. They thought they could trust the company. They were wrong. Al got non-Hodgkin's lymphoma in 2011. They kept spraying because they didn't know. They didn't know why. Alberta got non-Hodgkin's lymphoma in the brain in 2015. They got it again in 2016. It wasn't until, sadly, they saw a lawyer's ad that they realized there was a connection between Roundup and non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Now Alberta needs $21,000 worth of medicine a month or she dies, and that's the end of it.
Last August, I stood here after the Johnson verdict, and I told you that things needed to change. Well, they haven't. Monsanto keeps denying that it causes cancer, and these two fine people here are casualties of that deception. This is going to continue until Monsanto and now Bayer takes responsibility for its product. People are dying. People are getting sick. And they have no idea that it's being caused by Roundup. This verdict, $2 billion in punitive damages, is as clear of a statement as you can get that they need to change what they're doing. And I hope to God I do not have to stand here in 6 months or another year with another person who's a victim of this type of fraud. Monsanto needs to change its conduct. The writing is on the wall. Three juries have spoken. And people like the Pileads deserve better. This was a statement, and I hope Monsanto's listening.